Hello, I'm Jeremy from Synology UK. Thank you very much for joining me today on this session where we're going to be talking about backup and disaster recovery solutions. A quick look at the agenda. First, we'll be looking at how Synology is providing comprehensive protection for all of your business's workloads. Then, a brand new cloud-based solution which is going to give you a hybrid ecosystem to carry out all of your backups. And finally, we'll be taking a look at how we're going to enhance the protection of your Synology NAS. So, your data needs backup, I think that goes without saying. But importantly, so does your business. And what I mean by that is that when disaster strikes, it's not just files that you can get access to, but entire workflows, entire business processes, and that you can restore these within the shortest possible recovery window. So, whether you're a small business customer, or maybe the IT manager for a prominent customer like UNESCO or Unilever, our engineers are dedicated to making Synology backup solutions the best possible choice for you to back up not just your organization's data, but daily operations. So this dedication has meant that in recent years, Synology backup solutions have reached a high level of maturity. And what I'd like to do now is just take a quick look at the key requirements that customers are looking for in a modern backup solution. First, it's important that it can protect workloads wherever they are. It can be on physical infrastructure, it can be on virtual machines, but increasingly it's also in the cloud. The solution needs to be highly centralized, easy to manage, and also you need a lot of flexibility. There are times when you want full system level protection, that's bare metal. Other times where you want more flexibility, more granularity to be able to restore file by file. Now, don't get me wrong, a good product is obviously important, but increasingly, customers need to trust the organization behind that product, because that is what's going to guarantee that they continuously get updates on the software, as well as prompt security fixes when needed. Finally, and this is often overlooked, the software needs to be an integral part of the backup solution. That is what guarantees the best level of performance, but also the best customer experience. So our engineers have worked hard to meet all of those requirements, but also solve one of the key problems that IT administrators are faced with when they're, well, backing up all of the data and workloads of a business. And that is that, well, these workloads are scattered over the various platforms that I mentioned. And that scattering means that on average, they need to resort to 4.1 backup solutions. So our goal is simple, provide you an all-in-one solution to protect all of your business workloads on one single device, your Synology. And the software that makes that possible is our Active Backup Suite. It protects anything from internal workloads, Windows machines and servers, VMware, Hyper-V environments, to key cloud services. We support Microsoft 365 and Google's G Suite. Now, Active Backup is proving extremely popular. And as of September 2020, we're very proud to announce that it is protecting over 2.6 million users on computers, virtual machines, and cloud accounts. We obviously want that number to carry on growing. Active Backup is going to evolve, so I'd like to share with you what's on the horizon, what's on the roadmap, and really that means protecting new platforms. When we talk about platforms, Linux is always a prime candidate. It's actually really critical for the server market, where you may know that 1 in 3 web servers is powered by that operating system. So until now, we had support for file-based protection. We're currently working on an agent, and really what our goal is to bring all of the great protection capabilities available for Windows machines and bring that to the Linux platform. Obviously, that'll mean bare metal, backup, and restoration. So if you're protecting a Linux server, you'll be able to take its backup image and power it on in a hypervisor. And that is really going to expand the capabilities that you have to craft the perfect disaster recovery strategy. Now, when talking about Linux, we often get asked about supported distributions. Well, it'll be all of the key ones, CentOS, Red Hat, but also the more traditional ones like Ubuntu, Fedora and Debian. Now let's move on to another important platform, which is macOS, the second most popular operating system in the world for workstations. Now, considering we already have a solution for Windows, adding something for Mac means that we can protect over 98% of workstations out there. Now, again, this is under development, but it won't just be an agent for Active Backup. We'll be leveraging all of this key technology and bringing it to that cloud-based solution, which I'll be detailing later on. So again, bare metal protection will be available. And I want to say a few words on how we do that for the changebot tracking and the snapshots. Rather than having separate drivers, we'll be leveraging the native tools of macOS. And that means the lowest possible level of impact on your system. Okay, so in terms of support, it'll be Catalina from day one. You may know that this is already upgraded on 60% of the Mac user base out there. And as months go by, that's going to trend towards 100%. Now, whether you're a Linux user or a Mac user, if you're using Synology, chances are you care really about control over your data, data security in general. We want to make sure you never have to choose between that and the efficiency of your backups. So two important updates. First, we are supporting AES-256 encryption. It's military grade and therefore the optimal level of protection for your backups. On top of that, you can also enable compression, which will realize storage savings of up to 40%, further reducing the cost of your backup solution. Now, a lot of customers hesitate to enable these features, particularly encryption. And the reason for that is that they worry about, well, the impact on performance. There won't be any of that with Active Backup, particularly of global deduplication, which remains completely unaffected. So we're talking about platforms. We need to talk about software as a service, which is gaining massively in popularity. And that calls for effective backup methods. Customers are actually often surprised to hear that. But if you read Microsoft and Google's terms and conditions, they actually don't just recommend, but remind you that you have to, well, protect and replicate all of the data that you hold in their clouds. Active Backup already has been for the past 2-3 years providing a solution for that. It allows you to protect drive data, emails, calendars, contacts, but also SharePoint for Microsoft users. You can do that on a schedule, but also on continuous backup so that you don't miss any changes. And to make those backups as efficient as possible, we support single instancing. Now, there are two sectors where Active Backup has been adopted at an even higher rate. It's education, as well as public sector, particularly government institutions. Those two sectors often have challenges of their own, and it's often around the number of accounts, which can number in the thousands. And we often get asked, well, how many accounts can you protect with Active Backup? To answer that, best is to share what a current user is doing. On a Synology rack station, RS3617 XS Plus, he is protecting over 200,000 Microsoft 365 accounts. It's a pretty impressive number, and I really think it speaks to the quality of Active Backup as a solution to protect your business's data and workloads. Now, just before I show you a demo, what I'd like to do is give you two important updates. First, with such large-scale deployments, chances are you'll be using Microsoft Groups. What we're going to be doing is making it possible to leverage them on the setup and really streamline that when you're setting up an Active Backup task. And also, we have backup cloning. Customers will be able to confidently pursue a 3-to-1 backup strategy and do that effortlessly. But also, if your business is booming and you want to upgrade to more powerful and larger Synology units, you'll be able to use that to get all of the backup data of Active Backup and its configurations immediately available on the new units. Okay, so I said we'd take a look at a demo. It's going to be about how we can easily leverage these Microsoft groups. So here we're in the Microsoft 365 Admin Center. We've got 6 groups created, some for admins or staff, and there's 2 important ones. It's the marketing team and the sales teams. So how can we leverage this to create a backup task to protect all of the accounts of these 2 groups? You can see here, we've entered the credentials already. Just a few seconds to get authentication to the cloud. And then there's a bit of like the basics of the task. Give it a good name. I'm going to call it sales and marketing because that's who we're protecting. Just after that, you choose a destination, so where the data will be on the Synology. And then it's backup list. We're going to edit that and define who is going to be protected in the task. Just as before, you can select or deselect accounts manually. You have full control. However, to streamline things, you may want to go to the Groups tab. And there, in a single click, you can protect all of the marketing accounts. A second click, all of the sales ones. So it's really that simple, and it's going to really simplify your life when protecting large-scale deployments. Then we reach enabling auto-discovery. That's really great when employees join further down the line. They'll be automatically detected. You can define which data will be protected or not. And you can also define a behavior for groups that you create later on. So again, that's very, very useful. So we're just going to wrap up this task creation. It's already finished. So I think you can see how, in less than a minute, you've been able to protect potentially thousands of accounts in these 2 teams. Now, this ease of use goes way beyond just a wizard or the integration with groups. It starts from the installation in the package center, one-click installation, and it's all you need to do. Everything is taken care of. That often really wins over enterprise customers who don't We expect it to be so simple when using a NAS to protect such large-scale deployments. I mentioned the centralization of the solution. Everything is available from a single console. So just having a global view for a dashboard to be able to creating tasks, restoring data. Now, integrating the hardware and the software is a very important aspect to deliver the best possible level of performance. And with global deduplication, we're very proud to deliver rates that are often higher than third-party, very well-established solutions, but don't have that advantage of controlling their hardware. For virtualization environments, we have agents protection of VMs. You link the hypervisor, and then all of the virtual machines on it, within just a few clicks, you can protect them. And then when you want to restore a virtual machine, instant restore to a hypervisor of your choice really simplifies your life. Now, these are just a few of the benefits and key features of Active Backup, but have really made its popularity. What we want to do is very simple, bring these great features to even more platforms. Now, that'll be Linux, macOS, which I've already mentioned, but also more platforms that you can back up to. And I think you can see where we're going here. We'll be adding a cloud option. And what is the best possible cloud option to add? Well, it's going to be our own Synology C2 Public Cloud Service. If you're not familiar with it, we introduced it a few years ago to allow our customers to protect their disk stations, rack stations, to a cloud provided by Synology, all within the same ecosystem. It's proved massively popular. The single largest setup is over 200 terabytes of protected data. Every month, there's tremendous growth with 2 petabytes of C2 storage being purchased by our customers. And after trial, there's a 95% activation rate. So we want to bring C2 to, well, protecting all of the data and workloads within your business. Let's just give a bit of perspective. In the center, you have all of your endpoints, that is computers, virtual machines, and cloud accounts. Until now, the best practice was to protect it to your Synology NAS through Active Backup. That's an on-prem solution. But some customers need to have a more flexible hybrid model and backup to the cloud. That's where C2 is going to come into the picture. And importantly, you're protecting the endpoints directly to C2. It's going to really give you much more capabilities as an IT manager. And importantly, it's not a binary choice. It's not one or the other. It's going to allow you to have a hybrid ecosystem for your backups. Now let's dive into some of the more specific benefits to adding C2. First, it's a pay-as-you-go model. Smaller customers like startups who can be cash-strapped, it gives them much more flexibility on the initial investment. Secondly, I don't need to tell you that throughout the world, an increasing number of employees are working remotely. And it makes a lot of sense to protect their endpoints, their laptops, directly to the cloud. Because for you as an IT admin, it means there won't be an impact on the inbound traffic of your corporate network. And finally, it's going to really streamline the deployment, make it much simpler, and also reduce the effort for your IT team to maintain it further down the line. So I think you can see just how big a milestone adding C2 is. Very simple idea, but it's really going to enhance the capabilities for your backup solution. However, for a lot of customers, DSM and the Synology NAS will still remain the key node to protect the business's data. Therefore, it's very important that we provide the full level of protection that these Synology NASs deserve. And I've mentioned this for other platforms, we're going to be bringing bare metal protection to our DSM OS. Again, you'll be able to spin up a DSM image into a hypervisor. And importantly, it won't just be our own Synology Virtual Machine Manager hypervisor. It'll also include third-party ones like VMware and Hyper-V. I know a lot of IT admins were really looking forward to that, so great news, it's on the roadmap. Bare metal brings a lot of capabilities. However, some customers still need more traditional backup methods, methods that give them more granularity and flexibility on the restoration. For them, configuration backup makes a lot of sense. So what's new in DSM-7? Well, when you set up your Synology and log the Synology account, in a single click, you can enable the auto backup of DSM configurations. And from then on, you can just sit back and relax. No further input is needed. All these configurations, from user accounts and their passwords to more specific security settings, they'll be continuously replicated to the cloud. And when you set up a new Synology system or restore one, through that Synology account, you can bundle back all of those configurations. So that is actually going to be part of a very powerful disaster recovery method, not just for the configurations, but also for the data, because you can tie this in with Synology C2 Hybrid Share, which is also being introduced in DSM-7. If you want to learn more about this disaster recovery method, do check out our session on hybrid cloud. An increasing number of our systems are being used in enterprise deployments. It's important that all our backup apps meet those type of requirements, and that includes Hyper Backup. I like to describe it as our Swiss Army knife of our backup applications. It protects your Synology to any type of storage, a connected USB drive, another server, or even select cloud services. So what's new in DSM 7? We're going to increase the number of packages protected to 38. And by protected, what I mean is and their data and their package configurations. And the reasons that that is going to be important is that when you restore a system, the fewer manual configurations you need to do, the less downtime. So again, 38 packages, which are going to include Synology Drive, Synology Cement Station, a great one for creating a hybrid cloud, Cloud Sync, as well as CMS or Central Management System for enterprise deployments. It allows you from a single Synology host to manage hundreds or thousands of Synology systems. So on the topic of distributed setups, we are also going to be supporting admin delegation for Hyper Backup users. How's this beneficial? Well, if you're a global IT admin and you have multiple subsidiaries, you may want to let the local admins do certain things like create a backup task, maybe edit it, or even trigger it, but you don't want them to be able to restore because that could potentially overwrite key system settings. And that means, well, you'll have the perfect mix of flexibility, but also security. So we're reaching the end of this session. When I started, I talked about how important it was for a modern backup solution to protect not just files, but entire business processes, and importantly, allow you to restore them within the shortest possible time frame. I hope this has shown you what our vision is to make Synology the best possible choice for you to protect all of your business's data and workloads. So let's recap the three key ideas. Protecting all workloads means on whichever platform the data and workloads are located in. Synology will go into that field and protect it for you. Now, on top of platforms we already protected, Windows, VMware, Google's G Suite, we're going to be adding three important ones, Linux, macOS, and our own operating system, DSM. Then there's this idea of hardware and software integration. That's really important. It's made our success until now, so we're going to carry on in that direction. And really, it allows us to guarantee the quality of the solution we're bringing to our customers. By quality, what do I mean? Well, it allows us to remove compatibility issues. It allows us to deliver the best possible level of performance. Remember the great deduplication rates that we can achieve. And finally, it means no hidden costs, such as software licensing fees. Now, that is really important to us because although increasingly a lot of our customer base are enterprises, traditionally it has been SMBs. They've been loyal to us. We'll have that commitment to them that no Synology customer will ever have to compromise on the quality of their backups due to budget concerns. And finally, there's the idea of a Synology ecosystem, the hardware, the software. Well, now we're adding the cloud node. You have your NAS for the on-prem solution. Synology C2 is going to be the cloud part of the ecosystem. And importantly, for Synology customers who generally want to have complete control over their data, it means that all of the backups stay within the Synology ecosystem and you never need to have a third party involved. Last, it allows us to streamline the user experience. And I think the best possible example I can give you is that when you need help, it might be for troubleshooting, it might be for setting up the system, or there's only one team that you need to speak to, it's the Synology team. So I hope this session was informative and has really shown you how we want to make Synology the best possible choice to be your one-stop solution to protect all of your business's data and workloads. Thank you very much for joining me today.